Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to Central Bank of India earnings conference call hosted by Antique Stock Broking Limited. As a reminder, all participants' lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star, then zero on your touch-tone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Prabal Gandhi from Antique Stock Broking Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone, and I welcome you all to the earnings call of Central Bank of India. We have with us today the entire management team, represented by Sri M. V. Rao, Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer, Sri Alok Srivastava, Executive Director, Sri Vivek Wahi, Executive Director, Sri Rajiv Puri, Executive Director, Sri Mukul N., CFO, and the other team members on the call. Without further ado, I would hand over the call to Sri M. V. Rao, sir, for his opening remarks, post which we can open the floor for question and answer. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Very good afternoon, and welcome to all participants. Thank you for sparing your time. Before presenting business highlights, let me share some of the information on the activities as an organization we have carried out in the previous quarter. Number one is we have started Central Connect. This is the campaign what we started to bring back our own customers who left us in the last 5 years. There is a very good response. And then we have fine-tuned our processes to improve the efficiencies. And also, we have brought changes in our structure, and we brought the CPAC, that is approval center concept, to bring the confidence in our field functionaries to take the credit decisions. These are all on the activities part. Now coming to the business highlights, let me share with you the net interest income, NII, has improved from 2,354 crore to 2,495. That is 5.99% increase on YOY basis, and also 16.86% on quarter-on-quarter basis. And on the operating profit side, it has increased 1.08% YOY basis and 29% on quarter-on-quarter basis. And with this sustained performance, we have registered net profit of 250 crore compared to net profit of 161 crore on Y2Y basis. That is 55.28% increase on Y2Y basis. And on quarter-to-quarter basis, there is an increase of 21.36%. And coming to the CRAR, it has improved from 12.34 to 15.38% on YOY basis. And on quarter-to-quarter basis, it is 14.88 to 15.38. And gross NPA, slightly reduced. It is now at 15.52%. And net NPA, which was 5.60%, in September 20, now it has come down to 4.51% on YOY basis. And from quarter to quarter, it was 5.09 in June 21. Now it is 4.51 in September 21. Likewise, this provision coverage ratio is improved from 82.24% to 85.86% now. We stand at 85.86% on the provision coverage ratio. And NIM has improved from 3.21% to 3.36% on YOY basis, and quarter to quarter basis it is 2.84% to 3.36. And you know very well that because of our network and larger presence in the rural and semi-urban centers, we used to maintain the leader role in the CASA. Now it stands at 49.79%. And coming to the network, brick and mortar branches continue to be our forte, and now with the increasing adoption of the BC network, total customer touch points now reached at 15,185 as at the end of the September. And the plans what we have at the BC outlets is it will be ramped up to 15,000 by March, and by December we will be reaching around 12,000. Coming to the top line, deposits, the total business is 5.12 lakh crore, that is 2.27% YOY growth. and total advances is down by -0.96. But if you take the 4,810 crores which we have written off in the month of March, if we compute that, then our growth will be 1.75% on the advances side. In the deposit mix, already I shared with you, the most important and heartening is the CASA, which we are at 49.79%, and total deposits stood at 3.36 lakh crores. And in the advances mix, earlier we have given you the guidance that 70-30 will be our objective, and for this financial year we will be striving to reach 6% and 32, that is 68 will be the RAM and 32 will be the corporate. And now RAM has reached 66.79%. If you see a year back, it was 63.94. Now we are at 66.79, and we stand by our guidance that our objective is to reach, and we will be 68 to 70% in between by the end of this financial year. Regarding the mandated targets, we have achieved all the mandated targets under agriculture and the priority sector, small and marginal farmers, and weaker sector. And more so, I would like to share that we have sold PSLC, that is priority sector lending certificates, to the tune of 15,000 crores in this off year. So we have earned a sizable income from that. Regarding the credit support, we were there in the ECGLS 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Altogether, we have given around 3,478 crores under COVID support schemes. Regarding the standard advances rated, earlier it was 76.08, now we are at 79.53%. There is a good increase as far as the rating. Accordingly, risk weighted assets has also come down. Coming to the retail segment, our home loan YOY growth was around 5%. In auto loan, it is 6.5, and education, there is a degrowth. Other retail loan, there is an increase of 3.86%. And in this retail, let me share with you, just 1.5 months back, we started our co-lending arrangements with NBFCs, where we have already disbursed around 380 crores, where the sanctions was more than 500. Going ahead, this will be a separate vertical, and bank is eyeing to reach at least 3,000 crores by the end of March. Regarding the SMA, if you see from June 21 to September 21, I have not given the September 20 because of the moratorium and other issues. You are also aware they are not the comparable figures. Here, if you see above 5 crores and up to 5 crores, both the figures we have shared on in the presentation. Both in June 21, SMA 1 and 2 were constituting 5.38%. Now it is 4.86, there is a reduction, and going forward also we are confident in reducing this SMA portfolio from the book. And if you observe June 21, above 5 crores, it was SMA 2, 1516. Now this stands as 222. So almost we can say that SMA 2, which we see that as a stress in the corporate book, almost it is only 0.13% in the corporate side. And coming to the restructured book, COVID resolution framework and all COVID related restructuring, that is 6014 crores that is there. And in standard restructured, which was restructured long back and continues to be under standard category because of its performance, that is 3136. And total restructured book, what we have is 9,150 crores. And as far as the provisions that we are maintaining for this COVID book is around 650 crores. Coming to the NPA classification, total NPA, which is 4.51 net NPA, and retail is 1.75, agriculture is 7, MSME is 5.7, and corporate and others is 4.52. and coming to the retail sector, within the retail sector of 1.75, we have housing is 2, and vehicle is 0.42, 4.2 is the education loan, other personal loan stands at 0.75. Provision coverage ratio, which I shared with you, which was 82.24 in September 20, now it stands at 85.86. and the slippage ratio, now it is at 1.45. And similar guidance we have given for this year also, that 1.5 to 1.75 in that range slippage ratio will be there. Regarding the net interest margins, now it is at 3.36. And in that 3.36, there is a small clarification what we have given because of the income booked.
Sir, that was a 285 crore income booked in treasury of
If we subtract, then also our NIM stands as 2.97. So coming to the NPA movement, the opening balance which was there at 27,892, the total slippage 2,104, and reduction happened is 2,781, and again closing figure is less than the opening figure, that is 27,252. That is percentage of gross NPA stands at 15.52, and net has come down to 4.51. And regarding the NCLT accounts, we have a total around 22,399 crores under NCLT. Almost 98.67% is provided. Whatever the settlement that happens or resolution that happens in NCLT, directly it is going to add to our bottom line. Regarding the capital ratios, now we are at 15.38. That is CET1 at 13.41 and Tier 2 is 1.97. Regarding the leverage ratio, we are at 5.15. Coming to the financials, again, just I would like to touch upon the net interest income. We are positive on quarter-to-quarter basis and Y-to-Y basis. And in the similar way, on the operating profit, on Y-to-Y basis and quarter-to-quarter basis, we are positive. And provisions, on quarter to quarter, there is an increase of 30.94%, and the net profit, which already I shared with you, it stands at 250. If you compare with the September 20, that is 161, and June 21 is 206. Regarding the expenses, there is a good control on the expenses side, and more so on the interest paid, and there is a slight increase on the operating expenses that we know well that because of transfers and other staff related expenses that happened during the previous quarter, that has contributed for the little increase. It is not a matter of concern for us. And the provisions, now it is 1,151, that is the total provisions made for NPS 311. For return of debts, it is 777, and depreciation and provision for investment, including SRs, is 292, and for income tax, it is 103. And financial indicators, cost on deposits further reduced to 3.84. In the previous quarter, it was 3.93, and in September 20, it was 4.45. And yield on advances is 6.66, which is reflective of transmission of the rates to the ultimate borrowers, and also a lot of loans which were in September 20 around 12 to 13% under RLRR, that is repo rate link, and now it has jumped to 23%. So that is also having an effect on the yield on advances. Cost of funds 3.90, and credit cost is 0.72, and ROA is 0.29, and ROE is 1.09. Likewise, the business per employee and the net profit per employee also has gone up. Coming to our investment portfolio, just I would like to touch upon on one slide where you will find how this tweaking has happened for the past 6 months. And if you see the HTM, AFS and HFT portfolios of September 20 and September 21, in the AFS book, modified duration, which was 2.71 at that time, now it is at 1.95. And SLR modified duration is 2.37 in September 20, now it is 1.66. And PV01, that is SLR plus non-SLR put together, which was 14.51 in September 20, now we have moderated and brought it down to 8.29. and likewise for SLR PV01, 11.56, which was there in September 20, now we are at 6.07. That means whatever the book we have, it is totally insulated from the rising yields, whatever will be. And our estimation is even by December, even if it reaches 6.5, we are fully protected from the M2M. This is my brief presentation. Thank you for your time. Any questions, it's welcome. Now it is open for you. Thank you. Just before adding that, let me tell you regarding the PCA. This is only the bank now in the PCA. As far as the four indicators that what we have, we are totally above the benchmark. Even in the June, we have touched satisfied the four benchmarks, and now also capital adequacy ratio, now it is 15.38, net NPA is 4.51, trigger was the 6, and ROA now 0.29, and leverage ratio, now we are at 5.15. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask any question may press star and 1 on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may please press star and 2. Participants are requested to use handset while asking a question. To ask a question, you may please press star and 1. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We have a first question from the line of Ashok Ajmera from Edgecon Global Services. Please go ahead.
Hello. Good evening, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Good evening, sir. Please go on.
Sir, congratulations, Rao Saab, and the entire team.
Thank you.
For the fantastic results. We were expecting even in the last quarter also, we got a feel that this bank is now getting totally transformed and the performance will be better. Having said that, sir, I have got a couple of just information point and some queries. Sir, on these two accounts, Major DHFL and Shirai, what is our position in our bank? How much did we had the exposure on DHFL? How much have we got in cash and in bond? And in Shirai, how much provision have we done? If at all we had any exposure.
Yeah, we have the exposure in both accounts. In DHFL and Shrey, both were around 1200. It is only just supplemented. That's why there is no big change in the gross NPA. If you see the total of our gross NPA, there is a very little change in the gross NPA just because Shrey has replaced the DHFL. And as far as the provisions that are concerned, Shrey, we have already made 50% this time.
Yes. Proactive.
Okay, free 50% provision has been made. Sir, in case of DHFL, out of that whatever 34-38% or so total we got, out of that cash and the equal amount or little more than that is bonds. So what treat to that bond we have given, like out of this 1200 crore, if you have got about say 550 crore or 600 crore total, out of that maybe 300 crore bonds. So what treatment have you given to the bond and how much provision has been reversed?
It is a 313 crores, that is the bonds what we have received. And as far as the treatment is concerned, these bonds were issued by the Piramal, which is AA rated. It is nothing to do with the DHFL. So whatever the rating that goes and the subscription to these bonds happened. So it is just like another market operation. So there is no requirement and also necessity to make any provisions for this.
No, sir, but about even on the security or the bond, about 15-20% is required to be provided. Has that provision been done? I mean, on this bond, or it is 100% taken in the investment book?
It is 100% taken on the investment because it is issued by the Piramal, na?
Yeah, that is there. But even on the security, as a 10-year bond, anyway, so no provision has been made on that.
Yeah.
So how much total has come in the income? So this entire 313 crore, and also the cash part of about 275 or 300 crore, isn't it? That has all come in the income of this quarter?
Yeah, it has come to income.
And again that you said that 600 crore provision you have made for Shrey.
273 is the cash component.
Yes, sir. Good, sir. Now, sir, will you throw some more light on the slippages of 2,104 crore as against 1,281 crore? So one is that Shrey. So
1,200 is Shrey book.
Last quarter.
Yes.
So out of this, about 600 crore is the Shrey, isn't it? Or the slippages, how did you calculate this 2,104 crore?
2,104 comprises, just a minute, our GM recovery will give you the details.
Yes, sir.
Mainly, Shrey is 1,149 crores. Then next biggest is Panipat Jalandhar, 168 crores. Rest are all miscellaneous small accounts.
Okay, sir. So this is one of its kind. Means we don't have any such other lumpy account for the future.
No, corporate side, and we are not seeing stress on the corporate side.
That's why in our SMA 2, that's what I was stressing more. If you see the SMA figures, on the corporate side, above 5 crores, which was 3,157 in June 21, now it is 1,017 only, total. And SMA 2, which is most worrying always for any banker, which was 1,516 in June 21, now it is only 222. Going forward, we don't foresee much of the stress on the corporate too.
No, definitely. It's a very strong performance and control on the SMA. Sir, this 16,788 crore of SMA 0, 1 and 2, it includes, I believe, is 5 crore also, below 5 crore?
Yeah, both the things we have given.
Yeah.
You have seen a number of accounts above 5 crores, up to 5 crores, except total we have given, that is.
Good, sir. Sir, now since we are comfortable on all the parameters, what could be the reason according to you for RBI not taking it out, from the PCA when all other banks have been done with? How confident you are that after the September result, now soon we will be out of the PCA?
See, I have no comments to offer from the RBI perspective, but one thing I can make it very clear, we want to assure them once again, we are going back to the regulator through a letter through my SSM, saying that the factors which were contributing for the spike in provisions in the previous years, that is already taken care in this year. That means this aging provisions which used to be high in some quarters it used to be less. What we did in this financial year is, for the entire financial year, we have calculated the total provisions that are required for the aging, irrespective of the recovery, which may happen also definitely. But as a prudent banker, we have taken the total provisions and we have equated for the four quarters. Even though in one quarter my provision requirement is less, even then I have provided in a such a way that it should take care the spikes in the provisions in the subsequent quarters. That means that we have evened out the spikes. So going forward, we may not have any problem as far as the aging provisions that are going to come in the next quarter. So the same thing which we are going to, in detail, we are going to elaborate to the regulator and also request them, to move us out of PCA. And one more thing, just I would like to clarify, PCA or non-PCA, it is not going to affect our performance. We will continue to do our best and we will be excelling in our area.
Sir, this, in order to have a better result of, what was the need of providing 100% for that fraud account of 130 crore in this quarter when we were allowed 4 quarters? So that would have given a little better performance also, though of course it is taking care of the future liability, but since it was allowed by RBI to be written off in 4 quarters, what is the reason of entire 130 crore being provided?
Same reason, same logic you can apply here also. The way we have evened out our requirements on the provision, that means we do not want to have any spikes.
No, so it's there.
In a similar way here also, same thing, same logic followed. I do not want to show one time more growth and more profit and next time again going down. No, consistency we want to maintain, and we will show and demonstrate to the market this organization has come out of the woods and we will be consistent in the performance.
Sir, just last question on this co-lending. Will you give some color of the, I mean, how it benefits to the bank and how much, like you said, that 380 crore is already there and you have a very ambitious target of 3,000 crore or so under the co-lending scheme. How much is co-lending for gold and how much is co-lending for MSME and other which you have tied up? And how is it helping the bank as far as yield and returns are concerned?
See, number one, gold is a yet to yield appreciable number. It is in double digit only. It has to grow. Coming to housing loan and MSME loans, the co-lending concept, if you go into that, see, as a bank, in certain areas, I do not have the reach. Number two is monitoring mechanism, what banks are having and then what the NBFCs are having, totally different. And we are confident that the mechanism what the NBFCs are having, they are going to deliver more on the monitoring so that my whatever the stress I foresee in MSME or in retail may not happen in this co-lending portfolio. That is number one. Number two is I have a surplus of more than 30,000 crores now because, you know, my CD ratio is very, very low in the entire banking industry. Now I am searching out for the avenues where profitable deployment will be there, and also whatever the risk that is arises on account of lending will also take in care. On the both the fronts, this co-lending model works well, and that's why we have gone into this arrangement. And going forward, we will be having tie-ups once this stabilizes. That's what I indicated in the previous quarter also. Now,
yes,
within a month or two, once this stabilization happens, we will be going for the more tie-ups.
So there you give 80% and this NBFC, they give 20%, isn't it?
Yeah.
80-20 is then.
Sir,
our interest rate remains competitive in this?
Yeah, definitely.
They are competitive. Sometimes we are better off than in our usual direct lending. So it is very competitive.
Thank you very much. Mr. Ajmera, please come back in the queue. Thank you very much. A reminder to the participant to ask a question, you may please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Ashlesh Sonjay from Kotak Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Hi, sir. Just one question from my side. I wanted to know on our corporate NPA book, which are the accounts where we expect recoveries during the second half of FY22?
In the second half, we are only just hoping for the NARCL to start their operations so that whatever the identified accounts, which are seven in number and maybe amounting to around 3,000 crores may move out of our books. 2,570, if precise.
Okay. And sir, anything apart from NARCL?
Apart from NARCL, right now we are not seeing any visibility in bigger accounts.
Maybe Videocon, but
we do not
again mired in lot of legal tackles.
Correct.
Okay, understood. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much. Anyone who wishes to ask any question, may please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Suhail from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir, and congrats on a good set of numbers.
Good evening.
Sir, a few questions from my side. One, I just wanted to understand in terms of this SMA portfolio a little better. So if I look at basically the SMA portfolio below 5 crores, that is at around 15,700 crores.
Yes.
So how comfortable or basically how worried are you in terms of these portfolio, and how does this portfolio behavior is different from the pre-COVID level? If you could just help understand that.
I would like to bring you back to the June 21 figures.
Right,
3,599 is the SMA2. Earlier also I clarified that SMA2 will be the much more worrying factor for all the bankers rather than SMA0. So out of 305.99, if you see the slippages, what happened in the September is around how much it happened? September retail below 5.
It's around
600. So likewise, even the SMA 2, which is there in September 21, is 3,539.
Right.
So going forward, what we see is we are having the war room concept here, and then it is working well. And then it is a controllable, and also we see that much of the slippages may not be there. It is only a controllable and expected lines only that slippages will happen. That's why our guidance just we have given around 1.5.
Okay. And sir, if you could just throw shed some light in your experience, how was this portfolio in terms of the pre-COVID? Because this portfolio is slightly on the higher side, and you may look at a declining trend going forward as well, right?
Yeah. Exactly. See, okay. COVID, what happened, you know, they because of the Supreme Court moratorium and all those issues, the figures won't give you that comfort to infer anything from that. Meaningful inferences may not be there.
Right. But
what we see is from the SMA 2 figures of June and September, and whatever the things that are slipping and the activities and also geographical areas, we are confident that the slippages may not be to the extent, you know, of, you know, what we cannot manage.
Right, right. And sir, is there any overlap between the SMA and the restructured books?
See, if in restructured, there would be, there may be a little may spill over here. But as a restructured portfolio, our focus, when it moves to this one SMA category, it will come under SMA category, but definitely, as you say, that little overlap may happen there.
It would be there.
And so finally, a broader question in terms of your strategy for probably a little longer time. If I actually look at one thing, slide 13, where you have given the standard advances exposure, I see that there is a lot of churning happening where your AAA proportion has actually increased quite significantly, and your BBB and even A has actually shrunk, and BB and below. So once we are out of the PCA framework, would our risk appetite be to go again into these segments and actually lend?
No, sir. Never it is going to happen. See, again, we do not want to learn the lessons again and again, okay?
Okay.
So, definitely this one, but your observation is quite right regarding the AAA.
Right.
What the churning has also taken place because of the conscious focus that as a bank, you know, we have a lot of CASA. This is one of the best in the industry, that is 49%.
Right.
My cost of deposit is only 3.8.
Right.
There is no point for me, even in the pricing, you know, I will always have the upper hand if I compare with my peers as far as the pricing is concerned.
There
we entered that market. So even though I am earning less, I know that it is dead sure that nothing is going to happen. So that's why our AAA has gone up, and it also aided us in reducing our risk-weighted assets portfolio.
Right. But sir, do you believe that actually the corporate cycle is behaving well, and because of the past experience, do you think that you may miss on the opportunities of making more money?
No. It's not like that. Even the corporate side, where we are very choosy, that's what I am saying. In the corporates, now we are maintaining the balance. We want to maintain the balance of 70-30, and in the near term, it will be 68-32. In the 32, we know very well what are all the assets that are maturing in this time. And we know the what type of assets we have to pick up. Even on the pricing side, I am getting the good return where I am confident and going for the SPVs where totally it is a ring-fenced mechanism. And we are totally avoiding the financing the hold cost now. And we will be focusing on the SPVs, and we should have a definitive visibility on the equity front from where it is coming and what is the quality and strength of that equity. And also when cash flow starts, total ring fencing should be there. So there is nothing from our side to abstain from the opportunities, but definitely as a bank we will be looking at the reasonably qualitative corporate portfolios.
Okay. And sir, in this one more thing, in terms of from the growth perspective, because our cost of funds is so low, are we actually capturing in terms of the customers where the financial institution or other financial institution may be at a given the loans at a higher rate? So is the balance transferring happening to us, or how do we actually look at the growth in terms of the retail and housing despite a lower cost of funds, sir?
See, retail and housing is entirely different ballgame. It is not much depends on the refinancing. As far as the corporate side is concerned, you are also aware now in this market, very few capacity expansions or new things are happening. Otherwise, it is only refinancing where corporates are reducing their cost of borrowing.
Okay, and there we are seeing the benefit that is reflected in actually growth in the AAA rated entities.
Exactly.
Right. And so finally, in terms of just if you could actually give an outlook in terms of how much would we selling down to NARC and broadly your recovery from the technical write-off, how do we actually look forward towards these two numbers in next 3, 4, 5 quarters?
Yeah, NARCL, we can give reasonably calculated numbers.
NARCL, we have 7 accounts which are identified out of 22. As you are aware, there are 22 accounts pan industry. And our exposure there is 2,507 crores. So the reduction expected through NARCL is 2,500 crores.
And sir, if you could also help in terms of the treatment, whether these would be written off or fully provided accounts?
Oh, some of the, like I can say out of 7, all of them are fully provided, 100% provided for.
So this will come as basically the provision write back in the provision line item, and the gross NPA will fall.
Yes, yeah. Whatever we recover, we'll add to the bottom line.
And the provision gross NPA will fall by 2,500 crores.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly.
Okay, so this is very helpful. So thanks a lot and all the best. If I have anything more, I'll come back in queue.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. A reminder to the participant, to ask a question, you may please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Amit Mishra from Indus Equity. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening, sir. Thanks for the opportunity.
Yeah, good evening.
I have two questions. Seeing the sir loan growth opportunities, which segment are we expected to contribute to growth for us? And the second question is, what is the recovery pipeline for second half of the year? That's it.
See, in the recovery pipeline, that's what in the bigger accounts, what we see is only NARCL, that bigger accounts will move out from our book. And then because since these are all 100% provided, that will be contributing to our bottom line in an appreciable extent. As far as the loan growth is concerned, it is on track as far as the corporate book, which we are eyeing for that 30, what I am again repeating, 30 and 32. So we are in a position to pick up the assets there. We never have any issues as far as the loan growth on the corporate book. Coming to the RAM segment, yes, now we are focusing more on the growth side, on the retail segment, agriculture and MSME, and coupled with that, it will be our co-lending will be complementing to this portfolio.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. The next question is from the line of Ashok Ajmera from Ajcon Global Services. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Thanks for the opportunity again, sir. So, sir, taking this our NARCL discussion forward, so almost about 1.5% of our gross NPA will come down in the next quarter when this 2,507 crore goes. So,
yeah.
Which becomes to our gross NPA will otherwise also come down to 14%, isn't it, sir?
Correct. Yes. Perfect.
And, sir, now one more thing, sir, in the case of the Shrey,
he objected to this action of the government, saying that I was solvent and I could have run the business with the restructuring and other things. So it means he is capable of paying the amount and the thing. So why? What was the need of the almost, I mean, full 50% provision? Is that informal message from the RBI? Because the other bank also today said that we also made 50% provision as against the 15%, which is mandatory required. So have you got some feelers that minimum 50% has to be provided for?
No, sir. No such type of direction or indication from anyone. It is only our own internal capability of providing that amount. Since we had that the opportunity to provide, we have provided. And whatever the Shrey's comments on this platform, I have no comments to offer.
Okay, sir. No, point well taken, sir. Answer well taken. Sir, in case of the DHFL also, though the settlement has taken frame and Piramal has paid you the cash and the bond, but still the banks are saying that we can still go against the promoters because they had given personal guarantee and there are some prospects of recovery.
Yeah.
So have you also assessed
that? Is open, sir.
Pardon?
That is there. Personal guarantees invocation is there.
Is there. So,
yeah.
So any assessment of some possibility of, I mean, any idea of some more?
No, speculations at this time because a lot of things are involved. Okay, that legal provision is there and everyone is exploring that.
Okay, sir. When I was abruptly cut in the first time of my opportunity because I had taken a lot of time, we were on the point of this NBFC and co-lending. So there I was asking you that, yes, it's a very good move. And you said that you have got a lot of, because your CD ratio is only 52.29% and you have a lot of cash, to deploy. So I was just asking whether in that case, you are open to A-plus rated NBFCs for direct lending also for the priority sector or otherwise?
No. Now, co-lending.
Co-lending route.
Through co-lending route only, we would like to increase our book there. As far as the direct financing to NBFCs, because we have internally fixed ourselves that we should be 10% of our loan book should be towards the NBFCs. Right now, we have around 11.7 or 11.8. That's why direct financing to NBFCs is not happening at our end, except for the exposure neutral lending.
Okay.
New one, maybe going forward, we may see, but not at this moment.
Yeah, because that is also another opportunity, because all these NBFCs are doing very well these days again, post.
We always learnt, risks are incubated only during the good times.
Yeah, Ashokji, Vivek-wise this side, if NBFCs are really doing well, that means they are growing more than 10%. If they are growing more than 10%, then for them also co-lending is a very good option. So,
that is okay, but there are some practical problems also, like especially I saw in case of gold loan, the security creation, the gap between the, there are... Anyway, those are the problems which, these are the teething problems because you are expanding your business in that direction. Because the main thing is, the security creation coming to the bank's vault and the certification, the valuations and all those things.
Correct.
So, co-lending has its own...
It's evolving.
But direct lending and especially to the priority sector onward lending, I don't think should be a problem. But anyway...
It's not a problem. Yeah. But only our internal, our own restrictions, what we have kept on ourselves.
All right, sir. So apart from this, your retail and co-lending, do you see any green shoots now in the business industry, MSME, some mid-sized corporates? Because unless you do that to increase the book size, loan book, I think only by retail or this very, very competitive product, you may not achieve that kind of a thing when you are so comfortable with 52.29% of the CD ratio and good capital adequacy now. So, are you looking at or are you working on that?
We are open to all all avenues as far as lending is concerned. Only base rule is we should not go back and repent afterwards. That is only the base rule we have.
I think I lost. Hello.
Yeah. Hello. Hello.
I think there is some interruption from my side only, or?
No.
Is it audible from my side? Is it audible?
Yeah, there were some interruption in between. I mean, I couldn't hear you fully. Yes.
No. Just what I was saying is, we are open to all avenues as far as the lending is concerned. Only principle and base rule what we apply is, we should not repent in future. That's all. That is only the base rule we apply.
No. That is, of course, that prudence is required, and the base rule of those kind is really. And because of that, the bank is now again coming back to, its past glories back. Having said that, sir, this on the treasury income and the what is your future outlook on that? And you said, I think, in some of the answering of somebody else's question, that you are very comfortable on the yield, and so how comfortable you are?
It's not that comfort we are deriving an account the way we have immuned our AFS book from the possible increase in yields that we are foreseeing, and we had that inkling, and now it is coming true what we expected as far as the yields are concerned. So in that perspective, we had tweaked and also shifted a lot of securities in the month of April. At that point, whatever the loss we have booked because of the shifting, that appears to be very small amount now what we have seen in the increase in the yields when it has gone for the MTM. So keeping that in mind, we have moderated and also shifted. That's why our modified duration and PV01, all the things are in place. Even for December, if yield touches 6.5, we are totally immune from that M2M loss.
Yes, because you got almost about 1,750 crores in this half year from the treasury operations. Look at your segment. In the segment-wise, this wholesale loss is...
Sir, in between it is dropping. Hello. I think we lost Mr. Ajmera. Connection. Sure.
Thank you very much. In the meanwhile, we'll move on to the next question. That is from the line of Mr. Suhail Halai from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. Sir, just a couple of questions again. One, if I actually look at your loan-to-deposit ratio of 52%. In the environment, what we believe is slowly and steadily the interest rate would rise, and probably the liquidity will get tightened. In this, can you actually tell me how far away are you from basically raising the rates or in terms of your deposits?
Right now there is no thought on that, and as and when the situation evolves, again our ALCO will meet and take the appropriate decisions at that juncture. Right at this moment, we are not tweaking any of the rates, and we are also conscious because of our presence in the rural and semi-urban areas, and also our demographic exposure tilted towards the senior citizens. We do not want to reduce the deposit rates. Even, at this moment, it is very easy for me, but keeping our commitment to the society and senior citizens' problems, our committee taken the view that let us not reduce the rates drastically, let us maintain, and whatever the liquidity we have, let us go for the profitable deployment.
Sir, let me rephrase the question. Say about 6 months or 9 months down the line, probably the private banks may start raising their deposit rates. Would we actually chase private banks in terms of raising the deposit rates, or we would be comfortable till the time there is liquidity in our balance sheet?
One thing I can tell you, we will be balancing our activities from the proactive measures and reactive measures. We will not be totally fully on the reactive side. When other banks raises, then we will think what to do. Or liquidity exhausts at our end, what to do. In that way, we won't go. We will be balancing. And anyhow, on daily basis, we have the liquidity reports on our MIS. We will be taking the conscious decisions on that.
No, I agree, sir.
It will be premature for me to forecast at this moment.
No, sir, I agree. The only question that actually came in my mind is probably in the medium term perspective, while we have very, very excess liquidity, this could help us as well as some of the other PSU banks, because the cost of fund differential will continue to increase as the liquidity tightens between us and the private banks. So just wanted to collaborate that with you. So second, in terms of, you have actually grown significantly as discussed in terms of the AAA book. But if I look at the current account growth, that is still muted. So are we able to, in terms of increase the relationship or strengthen the relationship with some of these large corporates? And your thoughts on that?
Yeah. That is the precise reason why we are entering into AAA with the, you know, pricing advantage what we have. And we have already worked out for the two big corporates how ancillary business can also be taken into, so that value-added services and also to their employees and retail loans to their employees, all sorts of things we have bundled together. So the way you see the private banks are making the ecosystem financing, some terminology. So we may not be using the terminology, but precisely we are doing the same activities. So that, you know, once we have an entry, we want to ring fence the entire cash flows, not only for the company, for also to their employees. Further added to that, we have gone one step ahead of taking their creditors and debtors information so that we can also explore for the further business.
Understood. So this is basically the entry point, and then you would be targeting the entire ecosystem.
Exactly.
Yeah. That's it, sir. That's it from my side. Thanks a lot and all the best, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. That was the last question for today. I would now like to hand the conference over to Mr. Prabal Gandhi for closing comments. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. On behalf of Indic Stock Broking, I would like to thank the entire management of Central Bank of India, MV Rao sir especially, for the time that he has given us, and thank you. And sir, would you like to make some closing remarks?
No, just I would like to assure all of you, first of all, thank you for sparing your time, and we would like to assure the market that we will continue to perform and excel in our operations, and whatever the interest you are showing earlier, please continue to bestow your such type of interest in our bank. Thank you.
Definitely, sir. Thank you so much. And with that, we'll end this call. Thank you, everyone, for participating. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Participant, on behalf of Antique Stock Broking Limited, that concludes this conference call. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.
Thank you.